What is up there, guys? So today I am seeing the swatches of the fabric that they're gonna use for my gown. I am beyond excited to just see everything. We're planning for my save the date video. I'm not gonna tell you yet what's gonna happen, but we are looking at my baby pictures. Look, I'm so cute.
Cute.
Look at that. Look at that. And then look at my brother on the side.
So I have about a month and a half before my big date.
Hi guys, a really exciting part of preparing for any birthday or your debut specifically is the food tasting. So now that's what we did earlier. I actually forgot to video it, so I'll just think that's a surprise if you're attending my debut. The caterer is actually K by Kunanan. And something that I really wanted to give importance to in my debut is the food. Because most of the time, if I attend something, I really look forward to the food. So food is very important to me. So we're done food tasting. And now we have to go to the hotel to check the rooms to see which one I like.
Okay, it is just a few weeks left before my biggest day in my life so far, and I'm pretty much okay with everything, but what's really stressing me out is the music that I'm going to use. So one of the most tedious parts of probably any event is your guests. You have to ask for RSVP, you need to ask for confirmation, because basically a lot of different suppliers and things you need to prepare are all really dependent on the number of your guests. So it's been really hard. My mom and I have been working for days just to get RSVPs from people. Tomorrow is my wedding day. Oops, sorry, my debut day. Okay, my friends, we have arrived. So this is the bed over here. And then we have the toilet over here. And we have a TV here. Then the bed is over there. Then we have a kitchen here. Then we have a table here. So, can I set up my camera here? It's pretty nice. Okay, I'll set my camera up here. Wait, so I had to remove my glasses because the glare was too much. So, wait, I need to get my notes. Wait a minute. This is one day left until my big day. It's just been in my brain, you know? It's like, so a lot of people might not know this, but I actually started planning my debut last year during my 17th birthday because I was bored with my day. Honestly, I just really had a bad birthday last year, so I wanted to make up for it this year. Okay, so if you are going to have a debut or planning to have one, or maybe you're so young but you're excited for your debut, that's great. And here are just some things that might help you along the way. So these are basically the suppliers that I needed for my debut personally. So number one thing when you are going to have your debut, you have to know what you prioritize most. So for me, what I prioritized most, that is the venue and the catering. So for me, if you have a great venue and if you have really great food, then your debut is pretty awesome. We did kind of splurge a little bit on the food and the venue. So for the venue that I got, I chose Blue Leaf Cosmopolitan. So it's really beautiful. It is kind of pricey, but not extremely expensive. It has really high ceilings, really great, really nice people. I love it. And then for the food, I did choose K by Konanan. They're honestly my favorite catering. Not that I have already tried a lot of different catering people, but they are the ones that I absolutely love. So those are the two things I prioritize. I will be leaving links to the websites of all the suppliers that I got for my debut, just to give you guys, you know, some options if you are looking for some. Okay, so the next one that you have to think about, your lights and sounds. So some people don't really mind lights and sounds. Some people do, but for me, I was pretty in between. So I really wanted it to be good quality, but it doesn't have to be like super up there, really expensive. So most of the time, the venue that you are going to get, they have these packages of getting like lights and sounds already with them. If you do not know any lights and sound supplier, then please do go ahead, take that package and go get the venue's lights and sounds, just so that it's less hassle. But if you already do know someone and you really like them, you've worked with them in the past, then don't get the package. The next thing that's really important is your host. They're gonna be the ones to transition to different parts of your debut. They're gonna be the ones introducing you when you open the door and walk down the aisle. They're just there to make things flow. And the next things that were also really important to me are the videographers and the photographers. In my church, there are actually people that I know that have their own videography and photography companies. So we already had them. So just really look for people that, you know, get the feel and the vibe that you're going for in your debut. Look for people who could tell your story or show your story the way you want it. That's really what I found with my videographer and the photographer. And the two things that I need to last was my gown and my makeup artist. So I have two favorite colors, three technically. One is gold / champagne, and the other one was white. So I was really planning to have two gowns. So what I did is my neighbor knows this designer, really affordable, and we got them two gowns, really cheap, really nice work, clean, I love it. And for my makeup artist, I have been eyeing this makeup artist. If you're Filipino, then you most probably know Moira de la Torre. And I've been following her on Instagram, and honestly, her makeup looks bomb. And I went ahead and stalked her makeup artist. Her name is Teresa Padin. I don't know if it's Teresa or Teresa. So I really got her. I really told my mom,
I'm not gonna get any other makeup artist than Teresa. So
done deal. So thank you guys for watching. I hope this was interesting. And if you are going to my debut, then I'm gonna see you tomorrow. I'm excited to see you. I am, I really am. And I love you guys from the bottom of my hypothalamus.